It starts young. So, I mean, even with your 1 and 2 year old, it's talking to them at those well visits about proper diet and exercise, even when they're 2 or 1 or 2 years old, making sure that they're even then starting. And that's the roots of obesity and poor eating actually start there. If we start off early, introducing good fruits, vegetables, protein sources to the kids, limiting their sugars, they're going to learn this is what I'm supposed to eat, so that when they are 4, 5, 6 and have more free rein, they're going to hopefully continue to choose those healthy foods and not just go for the snack foods and high sugar drinks. So it starts early, but again, each visit, you want to try to review their growth chart. And I like to, another thing with having the electronic medical record, you can pull up that growth chart and let them look right at it and see where they are with their weight and their height and their body mass index. So that each visit we're going to review that and talk about things. If it looks like we're doing great, keep up the good work and keep encouraging them in a positive manner. If there are things that we need to work on, then still want to do it in a positive manner, though. That's, I think, an important thing in pediatrics for sure, is you don't want to build poor self-esteem in the kids. So you want to look at things in an objective manner, but also address them in a nice manner, but also one that's going to promote change if there are things that need to be changed, whether it be cutting out a lot of sodas or high sugar drinks in the diet. And again, for kids, simple, small changes often will have a big benefit. They do have the advantage that they're still growing, so that weight loss, even if they can stay the same weight for a year or two, as their height grows, their BMI tends to drop. So it tends to be less dramatic in terms of what we have to do to help. And then there's a psychological component to it, particularly as the kids get older, that we have to address too, if there's any other feelings of needs that aren't being met and getting met through food. And then at the same time, socially, there's a lot of things that we work on too to try to help so the kids have the ability to get out and exercise, particularly in winter months here in St. Louis when it's cold. Some parents may not have the opportunity to bring kids to an inside gym. So it's trying to go over with the family what they can do with their means to, again, provide a healthy atmosphere both with eating and with exercise, and trying to make that a regular, just everyday habit for the child and the family.